Hey, my name is Hubbard, and usually I do gaming videos, but as I'm a full-time graphics designer, aka my office's IT guy, today we will talk about how to build a budget PC for Photoshop, also considering InDesign and Illustrator if you're on a tight budget. And I will also make some comments about After Effects and Premiere Pro, so kinda covering the Adobe Creative Suite as a whole. Good news first, it probably won't be as expensive as you'd think. Now the facts and information I share in this video both apply for new PCs and also for used PCs. The only real difference will be the price tag at the end, with the new PC being quite a bit more expensive. So it's up to your personal preference to choose between used parts on eBay, etc., or new parts altogether. Mixing might be fine too, of course. Now let's talk hardware. I will first talk about the suggested parts, configurations, and after that I will give an example PC of used PC parts for around 300 to 500 bucks. One of the most important things for any Photoshop PC is RAM. You can never have enough RAM when working with Photoshop, especially if you work with big images or images which are very complex and have a lot of layers. And if you wish to have other programs like InDesign or Illustrator, along with some browser tabs running at the same time, you'll be thankful for every single gigabyte you've got. As today, operating systems and many programs tend to need more and more RAM, the absolute minimum amount I would suggest is 6 GB, which is highly uncommon today, to preferable 8 GB of RAM. This will be enough even for images that are quite big and complex. But as I said, you'd probably want to run other stuff at the same time, and therefore I would recommend 12 to 16 GB of RAM, especially now that RAM prices are finally dropping again. It doesn't matter if your PC will use DDR3 or DDR4 RAM. The difference won't be really that noticeable in any Adobe software. We're probably talking about a difference of a few milliseconds here and there. So the speed of the RAM doesn't really matter, as you won't be able to notice the difference between slow RAM and fast RAM. Really use the money that you can save here for other stuff. The only important difference between DDR3 and DDR4 is that DDR3 based systems might only support a maximum of 16 GB of RAM depending on the motherboard, whereas DDR4 driven motherboards and CPUs usually support at least 32 GB of RAM. Now, as of 2019, 32 GB of RAM is only needed if you're planning to work with absolutely huge images. We're talking like 10,000 to 20,000 pixels in size, or if you're planning to heavily use After Effects and some serious cutting in Premiere. But keep in mind that in a few years, 32 GB might be the new 16 GB, as operating systems and software will use more and more RAM in the future. I sometimes seriously wonder if developers just get sloppy or how that's happening. As when I started using Photoshop 15 years ago, I was fine using 2 GB of RAM, which is unthinkable in 2019. So just throw as much RAM at it as you can afford. Now for the CPU, to be honest, Photoshop would actually be just fine with a 2-core CPU for most people. But as 2-core CPUs aren't really a thing anymore, I would recommend literally any Intel Core i3 or i5 CPU, as well as probably any 4 or more cores AMD CPU from the last 10 years. It actually doesn't make that much of a difference. As Photoshop isn't really optimized on multiple cores, a higher megahertz would probably be the thing you could focus on. But again, it doesn't matter that much, except if you're planning on heavy multitasking or serious video editing, as Premiere and After Effects definitely profit much more from a faster multi-core CPU. I mean, if you can afford an i7, cool, go for it, but be aware that you might be paying twice as much as for an i5 while only getting a performance boost of maybe 5 to 10%. Maybe a bit more sometimes, but you certainly won't get twice the performance anyhow. By the way, overclocking shouldn't be an issue for graphic designers. It's gamer stuff, and if you don't plan to use this PC for gaming, which you definitely could, to be honest, if you wanted, you shouldn't bother about overclocking, like, at all. Except if you're a pro and you would do it anyway. By the way, you should be fine with either the stock coolers or, let's say, some entry-level cooling solution, as your CPU usually won't be under full load for a long period of time. Once again, except if you're working in After Effects or Premiere. even if you use Photoshop, InDesign and Illustrator, everything all at once at the same time. Now let's talk about storage and hard drives. I highly recommend using an SSD for your OS and disk cache. As we're on a budget here, we are probably not aiming for those super fast and fancy new M2 SSDs, as used mainboards probably won't support them anyway. But you're also good with an average standard SSD of your choice, 256 GB at least, so you won't run into a full drive too soon. And of course, any number of regular HDDs for storage. But I absolutely and strongly recommend to always have a copy of your work files. I've just seen so many HDDs die over the last 15 years. Don't ever take the risk of a total data loss, just be sure, double safe. And if you can have the copy in another room in case of a fire or lightning strike, that's fine. The size of your disks depend on your needs, but HDDs are super cheap these days and used 500 GB or 1 TB HDDs in okay conditions start at around 15 bucks. My opinion, there is no need for a so-called RAID in a budget Creative Suite Photoshop PC. Next, graphic cards. Well, where do I start? Can you use a budget Photoshop PC without a dedicated graphics card? Yes, you can, but I would at least suggest to get a dedicated entry-level card like Nvidia GeForce 950 or a 760 or a 1050 GTX for around 50 to 100 bucks to benefit from some performance boosts and faster visual updates. Small bonus, if you can try to get something with 4 GB or more, go for it. You don't need anything fancy like a GTX 1080 or better, because especially for Photoshop the difference will be super marginal, unless again if you plan to heavily use After Effects or Premiere. A good thing could be to focus on Nvidia cards that have lots of CUDA cores, as some Adobe apps actually benefit from those. And there is a super cool list of Nvidia GPUs sorted by the number of CUDA cores, which I will link in the description below. And even though this PC is not designed to be a gaming PC, as soon as you install a halfway decent dedicated GPU, gaming is of course absolutely possible. You could probably call it a budget gaming PC with lots and lots of RAM and an SSD or two. Monitors! I do have a great tip if you're looking for a new, cheap, calibrated and Photoshop suitable Full HD monitor, the ViewSonic VP2468. I'm using it at work, it's around $250 and it kicks ass for that price, as super professional ISO monitors are usually around 1000 bucks. So let's calculate and recap with an example PC. I'm assuming that we will get an i3 or i5-ish CPU for around 50 to 100 bucks, including a cooler, depending on which model exactly we'll get. Then we need a mainboard to place our parts on for around 50 bucks used, maybe $10 more, maybe 10 bucks less, whatever. Then we have 16 to 30 gigabytes of RAM, which costs about 75 to 150 bucks. Of course, as I said, you could always go with 8 for the beginning to see if that's enough for you. I would suggest to get at least a 256 GB SSD. You can get them new for 30 bucks. I wouldn't buy them used because that wouldn't make much sense when they're so cheap right now. I would suggest to get at least 1 TB of regular HDD space to save your stuff for your files. If you can get a second one or an external drive to copy your files on. Also, if we assume that we will get a dedicated GPU, like the 960 or 1050, 1950s, GTX, something like this, we would have to pay around $100. Then of course we also need a tower and a PSU, which I calculated with 30 bucks each. That's a total of around 400 to 465 if you're buying everything on its own. But you could probably save a lot of money by buying a used office PC and just throwing a lot of extra RAM, an SSD and a dedicated GPU at it. So, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you've got any questions considering the build you're planning to build, let me know. Don't forget to like and or subscribe. Thank you. Appreciate it. See you next time. Bye bye.